Good morning, good morning.
Nasa kamay na po ng mga otoridad si Pastor Quiboloy.
Yes.
Ano po ang next step ng administration given, sir, na meron tayong extradition treaty with the U.S.?
Well, the extradition request is not yet there. Besides, the judicial processes that Apollo Quiboloy is going to have to go through now, locally, still have to be done, because we have what has been done is that we have implemented and enforced an arrest warrant that was issued by the court, and therefore. It is now within in the court's hands. Wala na sa executive ito. Kami sa executive, ang ginawa lang namin, in-implement lang namin, in-enforce lang namin ang order ng court. So that is the situation now. We will have to look at that. But for the moment, hindi extradition ang tinitingnan natin. Ang tinitingnan natin ay yung mga kaso na mga complaint na pinila dito sa Pilipinas. At yun muna ang kailangan niyang harapin.
Next okay. Question, Chona, please.
Hi, Chona.
Sir,
good morning.
Sir, anong participation ng armed forces of the Philippines? Bakit sila nandun? At bakit sa kanya nag-surrender si Pastor Quiboloy?
Well, ganyan naman talaga. Madalas naman mangyari yan na may augmentation sa AFP. But let's be very clear. This was a police-led operation. It was a police operation. Kung ano man ang involvement ng AFP dyan, ay, as I said, augmentation. As you can imagine, all through these past months na, all the intelligence services were involved, both in the police, both in the AFP, even our civilian intelligence services. Kasama lahat yan para malaman natin ano yung dapat natin gawin and what are the movements that can be attributed to Apollo Quiboloy, Mr. Quiboloy. At yan ang, kaya naman may augmentation. Kung maalala ninyo, nung una silang pumasok, after 24 hours, 36 hours, hapong-hapo na yung mga police. So ang ginawa namin, para marilyebo naman sila ng konti, ay nagpadala kami ng sundalo na AFP. That was about 2.5 weeks ago. Nagpadala tayo ng AFP para mag-augment, makapagpahinga naman yung mga police natin. But eventually, when that was okay, nung na pwede na naman yung police natin, we withdraw na naman natin yung AFP at ang police na naman ang nag-frontline. So, that's a standard procedure dito sa Pilipinas. Madalas naman talaga natin ginagawa yan. I think what you all want to know, let me take you through the timeline already, what happened here. Over the last 2-3 weeks, we have been getting messages and feelers. Alam niyo naman to, yung mga sinasabi, magsusurrender si Mr. Quiboloy, basta meron siyang mga condition na kung ano-ano na sinasabi na kailangan, may promise na hindi siya papadala sa Amerika, na hindi ano yung... At kung ano-ano pa. At alam naman ninyo, hindi naman natuloy yun dahil hindi naman maaari na yung fugitive ang nagsasabi kung ano yung mga kondisyon na sa pag-aresto sa kanya. Kaya walang nangyari doon. Patuloy, ngunit patuloy. Meron tayong mga feelers na nakukuha. At we were very clear to his people, his lawyer specifically, na hindi maaari na may conditions na mayroon siyang ilalagay. At lagi namin sinasabi, basta patuloy lang ang aming gagawin. You have to decide what you want to do, but we cannot. We are ordered by the court to enforce this order, and that's what we are going to do. And the putting of conditions is not an option for somebody who is actually a fugitive. So, this went on back and forth for the last 2-3 weeks. On yesterday, between 8 and 9 in the morning, we got another message from our contacts na sinasabi, handa na raw siya mag-surrender. Sinabi na, very good. O, wala nang conditions, wala na yung mga conditions na dati ilinalagay. At so sabi namin, fine. Pero sabi niya, sana may presence ng AFP dahil wala daw siyang tiwala sa police. So, fine. Yun ang ginawa namin. So, that was around, na-decide na, sabi ko, by 9 o'clock, I cannot remember the precise time, but by 9 o'clock yesterday, in the morning, I was able to say, sige, tuloy nyo na. Agree to that scenario. So, and that was it. So, tuloy-tuloy na pag-uusap. How do we do it? Where is this? Where? By, at 3:40 in the afternoon of yesterday, lumipat na yung C-130 papuntang Davao para susunduin na siya. And that is exactly what happened. Pagbaba ng C-130 sa Davao Airport, pinuntahan na nila ang compound at natuloy na yung kanyang pag-exchange. Dinala siya, sinakay siya sa C-130 para dalhin dito sa Maynila dahil kailangan ang unang naging kaso niya ay Pasig. So, doon muna siya haharap. And that's essentially the timeline of what happened yesterday. The events after things that were not really moving, kung hindi doon sa atin, yun na nga, pinasok nga yung ng police yung compound. Naghuhukay nga tayo dahil na ang intelligence natin ay sinasabi talagang nandoon siya. At patuloy yung aming operation. So that is I think the what convinced Mr. Quiboloy na wala na, useless na yung magtago siya, na dapat lumabas na siya. And so, well, I'm happy that I'm glad that this is over. We can now resolve and look at the allegations that that have been made against him. We have to, I have to commend our PNP. This is police work at its best. This is what the PNP can do pag led well at maganda ang ating pagkakaunawa at pag-coordinate sa iba't ibang ahensya. But this is what policemen do. They go after and enforce court orders and go after those who have been those who have had cases filed against them. At nakita natin, desidido ang ating mga police at ang instruction ko sa kanila. Etong last time, sinabi ko, pagpasok natin, huwag na kayong aalis dyan hanggat makuha na ninyo siya. And that's exactly what they did. Nakita niyo naman, you know, this is, we had to engage so many parts of the agencies, mga technical, yung mga intelligence services, lahat, kasama lahat yan. But it was, in the end, it was a police action that that brought Apollo Quiboloy to the arms of the law. The question that is being asked constantly kagabi pa hanggang ngayon, nag-surrender ba o nahuli? I think that is a legal question, pero ganitong iniisip ko, hindi siya lilitaw kung hindi namin hinabol ng gusto. Ang pagkaintindi ko, ang pag-surrender, pag sinabing surrender, I don't know, maybe the legalists can explain this. Pero ngunit ang pagkaintindi ko, ang surrender, kapag wanted ka, ang surrender, pupunta ka sa police station o sa, ewan ko, sa prosecutor, I don't know kung saan. Sabi ko, to an official authority, sasabihin, nagsusurrender na ako. Alam ko, may court order na, may arrest order na ako, kaya magsusurrender na ako. Hindi ganyan yung nangyari. Ang nangyari, napilitan siyang lumabas dahil malapit na ang pulis sa kanya. To his credit, ang sabi niya, yung mga follower niya, magpapakamatay para sa kanya. At ayaw niyang mangyari yun. So to his credit, he was still displaying a modicum of leadership to his followers. Kaya naman, again, I will stress, it was a very, involved police action, augmented, of course, by the AFP, augmented by the civilian arms of government. It was, once again, it was really through the efforts of what our policemen did. And once again, I stress that walang, kung merong mang nasaktan, ay may galus lamang, may sugat lamang, you know. No major injuries were, ano, sige, sa Tulakan, sa Girian. Ngunit wala namang nasaktan na, wala namang namatay, walang nabaril. Dahil walang ulitin ko. Lahat ng pumasok sa KOJC compound, lahat ng tao natin, ni isa doon ay may dalang baril. Wala sa kanilang may dalang baril. Dahil hindi mo na malaman eh, kung may dalang baril, iba yung nagiging usapan. Eh, yung instruction ko sa kanila, wala akong gusto masaktan. Hindi ko naman gustong saktan yung mga member ng KOJC. Dahil itinutulungan lang nila yung kanilang sinusundan na leader. Okay, bakit nila ba't natin siya sasaktan? Ba't pa tayo magdadala ng baril? So, ganun na lang. And so, again, this is how it should be done. You can't do this without hurting anyone. You can't do this without shooting anyone. That is what police work is meant to be. And this is police work at its best. Kaya congratulations sa lahat ng ating mga kapulisan, yung na-involved, yung behind the scenes na na-involved. Ang ating chief PNP ay talagang all the time, araw-araw nagre-report sa akin, sometimes two, three times a day, kung ano yung mga pangyayari doon sa Davao. So, it is really with some relief that I can say that at least this part, this phase of that operation is now over, and we now leave Mr. Quiboloy to the judiciary, to the judicial system, and siyempre, babantayan natin na tama naman ang mangyayari na lahat ng kanyang karapatan, walang nasasagasaan sa karapatan niya, wala namang ibabaliwala sa kanyang kahilingan, kung ano man yun. But again, there is no special treatment. Although he's a very prominent person, we actually, hindi na, kung kahit na may magsabi na gawin natin special treatment, hindi namin alam gawin yun eh. We don't know how what special treatment is. So we will treat him like any other arrested person, and we'll respect his rights, and we will go through the process. The process will be transparent. Everyone who is involved will be accountable, and we will demonstrate once again to the world that our judicial system in the Philippines is active, is vibrant, and is working well. All right? Thank you. Okay.